Okay, so we're going to go through Microsoft Stream, and we're going to start from the beginning, and we're just in Office 365 at our app launcher right now, and I'm going to left click on Stream. You can also use this on your mobile device, but it's easier to show it to you in a browser. And it comes up, I don't have any videos on here right now because I'm going to walk through how to do that. And the first thing that you do is you click to upload your first video. Now you'll notice this isn't looking for a web address. It's not a video that's online somewhere. It's looking for a video that you have. So it's going to be looking at your phone, or in this case, my Windows 10 laptop. And we'll look around. Let's say we're going to post this video about Excel. And a few things are happening here that you notice. One is you're going to give it a name, but it picks out the file name first to get you started. And it's scanning the video. You'll see that the thumbnails are going to pop up here. You can choose which one you want, or you can add a custom thumbnail by clicking the plus sign if you have one ready. So let's just give this a name. Let's say this is this was made by someone very talented on YouTube. And I'm going to go ahead and use it since it was me. And just as you would expect, Stream is going to want a description. So I'm going to say how to use Excel to calculate the age of, we'll say inventory. I need to sound businessy. And as we scroll down further, it scans the video. It tries to transcribe it itself. Right now, it only does it in English and Spanish. But you can tell it what language it is, and it has a big selection here. Let's say we're okay with this thumbnail. We don't need to do a custom one. But if you come down to the permissions, this starts to show a little bit of how Microsoft Stream shines. And this is kind of the heart of the product and what separates it from something like YouTube. You can tell here this is meant to work inside a company, or in other words, inside your Office 365 subscription with other people that are on the same organization. So first of all, it put me as the default user, and it's asking, hey, do you want to share it with any of your groups right away? So if you do want to do that, you just start typing the name of your group and it should populate. You can select that group. Now, everyone that's in this group can automatically see it. So display, and it's going to pop up on that group's page. But you can also give those group members ownership privileges, which allows them to edit the information about the video and change who can access it. Let's just leave this as is for now. But the other thing to know here is you can add individual people. But we'll get into a little bit more detail about adding it to channels. For now, we'll leave that blank. And there's a few more options here. So you can turn off the comments if you want. Just depends what type of video it is. And you can turn off the auto captions. We'll just leave that on. And you can manually add subtitles. These subtitles, you might have to manually add them if the video is not in English or Spanish. Or a lot of times when a computer tries to listen to the voice, it gets some of the words right, not all of them. So if you want to have it perfect, just upload the subtitle there. And you can share it from here, or you can just publish it. We're going to skip sharing it from here for now. We're going to circle back to the sharing options, and we're going to click Publish Now. So what Publish Now does is it takes those settings, which in my case were I could see it and that one group could see it, and it's posted it. So I'm going to come in here as myself. We'll go to the home page first. This is what we saw before. It looks a little bit different because I already have one video, so it doesn't say upload your first video. But we're going to start looking around from here. So you have the bar here that gives you the navigation. We could look at my content. I know it's there, but let's act like we're another user. We're going to go in and discover. We don't have any channels set up. We're going to do that in a minute, but we do have at least one video. And you'll see this is what I just uploaded. It has the stats. No one's watched it. No one likes it. No one's commented on it. Obviously, those will change as you go along. And let's do a few more things from this screen. So we can go back to this middle icon. And this will allow you to add it to more groups or channels if you want to change what you did when you uploaded it. And this will bring you back to the modification screen so you can change anything. But as you add more videos, this page will become a little bit more relevant. You'll be able to search through them if you want to make changes and sort it You're going to have an awful lot for trending to mean anything, I think. But if you search for them and you search for videos meaning Excel and you want it by relevance, you know, this will come up. But let's go up here and change this to channels. So there are no channels right now because you haven't created any. But if you want to create one, let's make a channel that's for the finance department. And we'll skip the description, but we know a lot of Excel is going to be in here. And we're going to say some QuickBooks is going to be in here as well. And we could limit this if the finance department already had a group, but let's just say it's company-wide. If anyone wants to learn this, they can. And click Create. Once we click through, we're at the finance channels home screen right now. Let's say we're going to follow it. But there's no videos yet, so I have to add that video to the channel. So we'll just go back to my video. Click on the plus button. And let's share it with my channel. Click finance. Your channel came up. Click save. And there we go, that's done. So if I go back and look at my channel, I see finance. It shows that there's one video in it and there's one person following it. You can imagine a channel for every department if you want, or if those departments are already in groups, I would just use those. Then you don't have to get into managing both groups and channels. And a few more things about the actual video itself. So if we go back to the video and I open it up, let's look at the settings for it. Let's turn the captions on and let's turn it on to auto CC because I haven't typed in or uploaded any captions. So let's see what it did for my video. I turned the sound off. Here we go.
Several inputs. The date diff function works by taking several inputs.
Now let's pause it right here. So here's one of the cautions that you have to be aware of when you do closed captions. If you have a video like mine, when I, hopefully I don't mumble that much anymore, but as you talk through things, it tries to guess. And I didn't say dysfunction, I said this function. So if you're trying to save time, do the auto CC, but if you want to get it exactly right, you need to go in and do that yourself. So that's it for the CCs, just be careful about that. Now, if you go to share this, there are some interesting options, but the first one to keep in mind, this is not sharing this publicly. The recipient still has to be an Office 365 user, and even on top of that, Office 365 within your organization. So that greatly limits Microsoft Stream, but at the same time, it kind of defines what it is, right? So it's for internal sharing, so you don't have to worry about this getting distributed in the wrong place. But if you want to give this to someone, but you don't want it to start until, let's say, 2 minutes in, you add that timestamp there. If you look at the URL, I just appended 120 seconds to it. So if you copy this URL and you, let's just say, email it to someone, they're going to start watching the video at 2 minutes. And you could email it straight from here. You could type someone's name in. It's going to pre-populate. Or you can embed this in a web page. So it's still going to be viewable only by Office 365 users. But you can control some of the settings here. So you can make it larger or smaller. They'll still be able to maximize it, but this would just be the amount of room that it takes up on the screen. You can set it to start playing right away. If you're like me, you don't really like your web pages to start right away and make sound. You want to be able to control that, but there may be a situation where you want that on. And if you make it responsive, that means it's going to automatically shrink down if there's a smaller screen size. I would think you would typically leave that one on, and then just the information, if you turn it off, the video loads without those stats on the front that you just saw. And after we got all those settings, then you would copy that URL and use that for sharing. And that's basically all. So we've uploaded a video, we've tagged it with all the relevant information, and then we've put it in a channel. So I hope that was helpful. If you liked that video and you want to see others like it, please subscribe in the lower right-hand corner, and then you can click the little icon of a bell if you want notifications as the videos are posted. Thanks for watching.